Yeah, I love taking in leads, whether it be, phone ups or, someone who a BDC person has said, hey, can you contact this person because they're, the TO to the salesperson. And it's definitely nice. Again, I love just creating relationships, especially during like the middle of COVID. I was helping my dealership set up like setting up how to get people to put down deposits over the phone, like doing e-signing stuff, like very simple things, just because I'm the youngest kid there and like they don't know how to do any of this. And I think it's so important to, again, I want to push the status quo of what a salesman, what a car salesman is. I want people to feel comfortable around me. I want to just be friends with them in a way, and it's a very, I like what I'm doing, but there's just I'm so conflicted in this point in my life, which is it's a good spot
Well,
to be in. I like where I am
there's a
right now,
couple of
though.
different places you can be right now, and there is no wrong or right answer here as far as like where you want to be and what you want to do. Look, you're 22. Taste everything. All right. Do not pigeonhole yourself to sales because you might find that you actually like enjoy the service department. And you want to talk about making and creating relationships that last an incredibly long time. You understand the sales side, you're building a relationship and then you sell the car and then the relationship's over. You know what I mean? It's like, being a service advisor, I'd have people come in, bring me coffee. Like, I mean, oh yeah. Like, hey, I'm bringing my car in for service today. I'm like, hey, Mr. Johnson, what's going on? And Mr. Johnson would bring me a coffee. Like, it was amazing relationship development, So like, look, there's two ways you can play this. Like, you're young, taste every single position in a dealership. There are so many to play when. You might actually find that the marketing department is where you enjoy, and that's where you find your happiness and you find your jam. You might find that the social media side of the business, which is insanely important, and dealerships do understand the importance of it. Don't know if your dealership understands the importance enough where they're actually willing to pay for it, but
It's
that's a
terrible.
different conversation. That's another. But just taste everything. So that's one strategy. Taste it all, and there's nothing wrong with that, right? The other strategy is like what I did is like I knew in 15 years I was going like what my end goal was. All right, like I was going to be a GM, and then I was going to be a dealer principal, and that was it. And then I just had to reverse engineer everything I needed to taste so that I could get to that point. There is no wrong or right. You choose A, you choose B, you choose blue or red pill. It doesn't make a difference. You got to choose one, right?
And I feel like for you, it was kind of the same path with both of those options. You knew that you wanted to be a dealer principal, you knew you wanted to be an owner, so you had to taste every position in order
Yeah,
to get
it was
there.
in line. So it actually worked out really well, but I got a lot of criticism for it because I was making very healthy, beautiful 6 figures a year in a sales position, and then I would leave that to go do this. And then they're like, well, can you come back and do the BDC and internet operations? And I go back to do that. And then I was like, I really like the marketing side. I'm going to actually train, develop one of the people that are my business development reps to take over my position so that I can actually jump down a payroll, but the goal focus on the marketing side of it, right? And then I wanted to be in accounting. I watched the ladies upstairs just literally yell and scream their
Accounting,
faces off
wow.
on how bad, it was for the service department. I was like, well, God, it's that bad. I want to know why. So then I left there and I went to the accounting side. Like, I tasted everything.